Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Lorraine Rimmelin. I'm from watercolorartisan.com. And I am trying to share with you all things about negative painting. Negative painting is when we paint around the object, not the object itself. So I bought these little cards at the craft store, and I thought they really were exactly what I needed for two reasons. One, it's so simple now to show you the negative and the positive shapes, because this is where the object appears when we paint around it. This is the actual object itself. That was one of the reasons I like these. The other reason was, these are wonderful to take into my class, my workshops that I teach, because now we have a form, an object, a stencil that I can now pass around and help the students now develop their negative painting and layers using a little bit more of a complicated shape. I need to put a wash down because I want to give my first layer of shapes a little bit of a tint of color. I can work just on the white paper, but let's put a little tint of color. Now that my paper is dry, I have started penciling in the shapes of this little stencil I have of the swan. And I just randomly put this down on the paper. At this point, the only thing is they should not touch. I could turn this one around. Let's let him face this guy. And I'm just going to outline them. I'm putting three down. I feel that's enough for this space. Now, you don't have to use stencils. If you like to draw and you have an object you'd like to draw, please draw it in. I just do this because I find it's easier to keep you away from your drawing skills, if that's what you're not comfortable with, and push you into just painting and enjoying the painting process. Now all I have to do is paint around the objects. Keeping my value light. And again, if you've seen me working with on other videos, you know that I don't like the background to be one solid wash. I like the background to have a little more life in it, meaning a little more color in it. So I like to be able to make sure that at this stage I'm adding a little more than just one color. I like my paints to mingle and flow in my washes. People ask me, what's the difference between a wash and a glaze? Wash is usually the first thing we put down on the paper, is considered our wash. And then we glaze over our washes. What's beautiful about doing these glazes, and you can see it right here, as I put down this pink color, look at the glow of that greenish yellow that just pops out from right behind it. And that's what's beautiful about transparent watercolor. You get to see the beautiful glow of the colors as you layer them down. At any point, if you feel you're getting too dark in value, please just add water. Don't worry, just add some water. Once I have covered the entire paper except for my original shapes, I am done. Please make sure you pull that glaze right out to the end of the paper. If we don't change the value of this area, when we put the next image down, it's going to look exactly like that same layer. That's why we must change the entire background. Again, it has to dry, and then we'll be able to do the next layer. The paper is dry, and I'm penciling in now the third layer of shapes. You can see I have one over here. I have one over here, and I'm going to put one right over here. So now is when they must overlap to start creating those layers. Sometimes in my class, I just tell people, don't start fussing around. Just drop them down and let them lay where they are. Because this is not the time to worry too much about our shapes and where they lay. Remember, we're just doing an exercise in negative painting. If we create a masterpiece, well, isn't that going to be wonderful? But really, we're just doing a fun exercise. Okay, those are my shapes. They're down. And next, I'm going to start to paint around the first layer of shapes. And now I'm painting around the second layer of shapes. I'm ready to start my next layer. I've penciled in 1, 2, 3, and this will be my fourth shape that I'm going to pencil in. Remember, when I'm doing this, I'm never penciling over any of the previous shapes. So I won't put a pencil line here, because I'm not painting. This is hidden behind this shape. Picture if I could pick this up, I would tuck it right behind it. So this will be behind, this will be behind, this one will be behind. And you could see now how I'm having less and less areas to paint as I keep filling in. But the beautiful thing about watercolor is, look how beautifully you could still see that gorgeous glow behind there. Look at how that changes when I lay that glaze over there. How beautifully it changes into this gorgeous color, and the glow is still back there. Oh boy, if you're like me, don't you just love watercolor? And how nice to have such fun things to do like negative painting. It's relaxing. You get to sit back, just paint around the shapes, and watch what happens. Look at that color up there. How beautiful is that? Okay, I completed painting around all of the objects. You can really start to see all the layering and the fun in this. I love all this added texture when blooms come in. I love the mingling of all the colors. I think that's what makes this the most exciting. And the fun part is the next layer will be of these much brighter colors. I'm penciling the shapes now for my final layer. I have one shape here. I have one shape here, the second. The third is here. The fourth is right over here. And I love this little bit of a blossom here. And I'm going to make sure that's part of this swan's, part of this swan. So I'm going to use that and pencil in this shape. Okay, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 additional shapes put down. Now the fun is there's not a lot of space to paint, but I have to paint inside these interesting shapes now. There's a little spot here, these little spots that will make this layer come out. I hope you had a lot of fun watching this video. Negative painting is my joy, my happy place. Thank you for watching. Please like below, subscribe to my channel. Leave me comments. I love to hear from you. Your suggestions have been so helpful. And they've helped me grow my channel, and they've helped me bring you what you need to know about negative painting. You have a great day and happy painting to you.